This video has been brought to you by Dissidia Final Fantasy Opera Omnia. Download today to join the spring campaign for bonuses and free multi-draws daily.
I will save you.
Impressive, is it not?
Within Kingdom Hearts, while the world of Quadram is still very mysterious in its own right, it seems to have a huge issue despite being a world that is neither light or darkness, according to the hints dropped by Luxord and Yozora. That it possibly deals with aspects such as war and weapons, very specifically weapons. As going there seems to be a huge fact moving forward into Kingdom Hearts Phase 2 thanks to the hints of Tetsuya Nomura, it is the secrets of the weapons that holds the true fear and the true problem of the people of Quadratum, Yozora, and the entirety of that of Verum Rex. And that is the heartbeat of lead. You guys already know, it's HMK once again with another Kingdom Hearts 3 going into Phase 2. I hope you guys are ready to enter the darkness. If so, like, favorite, share, and most importantly, subscribe to HMK and hit that bell to know when my videos go live. So with that being said, let's dive directly in. Thanks to what we see and what we know from Kingdom Hearts 3 and Kingdom Hearts 3 Remind, it seems that a dark truth is pervading that of Verum Rex and the existence of Quadratum. Thanks to what we see in the Toy Story world, in the secret episode with Yozora, and the Verum Rex mock-up trailer. Not only that, it seems that people gloss over what the heart of this theory could lead into the understanding of the Beat of Lead. And of course, the Beat of Lead being the Verum Rex game or the Verum Rex spinoff or demo that we can actually play within the Toy Story world, which gives us a big understanding of what could be going on in Quadratum that they need Sora's help or that is going to be a huge problem going into Phase 2 despite no light or darkness existing in that reality. Specifically, it deals with the existence of Gigases, the giant weapons, the mechs, that we can see in the toy box world, and the Yozora secret boss in which he summons them to go against Sora, and of course, the Verum Rex trailer, in which Yozora and his allies are fighting a ton of them. Along with that, some finer, more hidden details about the existence of Verum Rex and weapons and Gigases lie within the box art of Verum Rex, and certain locations that we can find within Kingdom Hearts 3 Remind. This goes along with the existence and importance of weapons that is conveyed to us, along with that of the acceleration of karma. As stated in the box art for Verum Rex, after a long fight, weapons have brought great benefits for humanity, but the karma that sleeps in humans will accelerate further. In the light of the warhead in the night sky, they choose to fight while feeling the pain of their hearts. Now, this is very important when it comes to the entirety of the existence of Kingdom Hearts, the Beat of Lead, and what lead could mean to us, the viewer. As we all know, lead is a pretty toxic material that is usually found within bullets, with guns being one of the most famous of weapons. And if we're taking that link between lead and that of weapons, of course we must think about Gigases being mechanized weapons that are being used by unknown factions within that of the Verum Rex trailer and possibly Quadratum. But it is along with the idea of weapons that we also have the idea of karma. When it comes to the notion of karma and our understanding of it, the acceleration of it can possibly deal with aspects of sin or guilt that leads to that acceleration within that of Vamrex. And that would be the acceleration of karma within someone's heart. And the notion of heart is no secret, something that is probably the most important aspect of Kingdom Hearts. And that's why we relay that to the beat of lead. Because if we're talking about hearts and if we're talking about beats, then it could be possible that the beat of lead deals with an interpretation of a heartbeat. And that is the revelation of this theory and what could pose as the most dark problem of Quadronum and Vamrex that Yozora and Luxord have to deal with, and that is the beat of lead, or I should say the heartbeat of lead. Humans that have had their karma accelerate act as a heart to these steel machines, the Gigases. That is why the game is indeed called the beat of lead. Due to the aspect of Kingdom Hearts dealing with, you know, hearts, these machines need a core, or rather a heart, to act as their heartbeat. The beat of lead, the heartbeat of lead. And this is when we get to a very important part of this theory, is because how Gigases work as they're presented to us within that of Toy Story. We see that Sora and even the Heartless are able to pilot these mechs, the Gigases. Almost as if they are acting as the heart of these machines, because that's what they were intended to be. That's how they were designed to be, and that's how they work in Vamrex, albeit a bit more darker than how we see it in Toy Story. And that is the deal with the idea of these weapons becoming a problem and connected to that of the acceleration of the karma within that of human hearts. The karma acceleration deal with humans taking on forms of crystal-like objects, as we saw with Sora at the end of the bad ending of Kingdom Hearts 3 Remind. At this point of this dark deal, humans that take on this crystal form after having their karma accelerated are more likely placed within that of Gigases in order to act as the pilot, or rather the heart, the core of these machines in order to power them. That makes them act as their beat of lead, the heartbeat of this lead. And in that sense, it would make them incredibly akin to that of Heartless, as Heartless are representations of the darkness within that of humans or of people. Humans that have their karma accelerated due to that of sin and guilt would be along the same imagining without that of darkness, since Quadronum has no light or darkness. And both of these aspects, humans that have had their karma accelerated and Heartless, are able to pilot these versions of Gigases, just like how young Xehanort said in Kingdom Hearts 3.
One heart's shadows fill the emptiness of another. See how they bring him to life? Like Heartless and Nobodies, they fit together.
With Heartless representing the darkness within a person's heart, piloting the Gigas, a human who has had their sins and guilt accelerating their karma also pilot these Gigases in a different way, possibly to absolve their sins. And this idea spawned off of the beat of lead, not only in name, but in terms of location when we go play the game in the Toy Story world. Check out this area. Here we see the rig that is off the coast of Quadronum. It looks to be that of a Gigas production plant, the main location of the beat of lead. And then see here in this one area, you're able to open up and dump crystal-like ore that is being carried around the facility. These are the crystals used to power Gigases. And where do you think they come from? Humans being the heartbeat of lead. And that's the most messed up thing about karma acceleration within the world of Vamrex and Quadronum. If these humans that have had their karma accelerated and becoming crystals are placed within that of Gigases that fight other Gigases and other humans, then those humans and other Gigases that are being targeted by the Gigas, along with the Gigas doing the fighting, lead to more guilt and sin on all accompanying parties, thereby accelerating everybody's karma in an endless loop, which will create more crystal cores from humans that have had their karma accelerate and thereby producing more weapons and Gigases. And that is the main problem of Vamrex and Quadronum. And this is why Yozora was probably told and needed to save Sora, as he would be a powerful core if his karma was allowed to accelerate. And Yezora doesn't need him to be put in a Gigas. That will be quite the powerful Gigas. And that leads into the finale of the 2 points tied to that of Quadratum, the Beat of Lead, and Yezora. But speaking of Yezora,
bring various universes together to end Oblivion in Dissidia Final Fantasy Opera Omnia. Join a huge community of players seeking to do the same with your favorite team of Final Fantasy hero and villains. Over 140 to collect. Take your pick among the boys from Final Fantasy 15, especially one of my favorites, Noctis. And did I mention that all characters are free to obtain? That's right, you can enjoy the compelling combat and the dramatic story with your favorite characters pretty much off the bat. While it still is a gacha game, the only thing you have to roll for are the weapons to enhance your character's abilities, in which they're incredibly generous. And if you're a fan of Final Fantasy XIV, Estola's powerful burst weapon, Truth Seeker, has finally arrived. So if you're down for that, generous rewards await new players, so now is the perfect time to join. Download today using the link in the description box below. Assemble your team, grab a weapon, and save the world. And I'll see you there in Dissidia Final Fantasy Opera Omnia.
Yezora is known to have his heart replaced with another, and due to that, was changed beyond recognition, supposedly. This may possibly be due to him and his allies attempting to dodge his own karma acceleration. By splicing the actions of his body against that of his true heart, he could dodge the acceleration of his own karma and not become a crystal core when fighting these other Gigases that are indeed powered by human cores. So in his own way, he can attempt to stop and destroy Gigases without having his karma accelerated. And to cap it off, that would easily explain why the Nameless Star is in the final world and why Yezora aimed to save her in the trailer. As in the Verum Rex trailer, it seemed that she had a grand power, but also she was targeted by a bunch of Gigases. That is because her heart, her core, could possibly be the strongest core for a Gigas if her karma accelerated, and thus being extremely desirable to convert into a weapon. And that is why Fairy Godmother knew if she were to return home to Quadratum, her heart would indeed be stolen. So the best thing to do to dodge such a fate and such a weapon being created was to flee to the final world where those looking for her heart can't reach her. And with all of this being said, this could explain why Luxor and Yezora needed Sora and was impressed by Sora's power, because quite possibly, with the importance of Sora and his power over the heart, seeing hearts in all things, the good in all things, he may be the one to reverse all of this karma acceleration and put an end to this crazy cycle. But for that, he might need a crown along with the seven. But that's a theory for another time. So what'd you think about the prospect of the heartbeat of lead when it comes to Verum Rex and the possible problem of Quadratum? Leave your thoughts and theories in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed the video, please share it up with your friends and Kingdom Hearts faithful. Like and subscribe to HMK for more awesome Kingdom Hearts content every week. Big thanks to my Patreon supporters for making this video happen. And big thanks to Square Enix for sponsoring the video. So guys, until the next one, this has been HMK and I'll check you guys later.
So you haven't subscribed to HMK yet. Don't piss Xemnas off.